वेलकम टू गेट स्कूल।
सो वी हैव जस्ट नाउ डिराइव्ड द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन जी वन ऑफ एस एज 1/1+ts। ओके, नाउ इन अ प्रैक्टिकल सिनेरियो हाउ डू यू कंस्ट्रक्ट सच अ टाइप ऑफ सिस्टम in electrical networks, how you construct such a system is by a simple RC circuit. Okay, this is R and this is C. What is the input and what is the output? The voltage across the capacitor is the output, and the input is basically the voltage across both R and C. Okay, how do you get this type of a transfer function for this network? If you know, the capacitive impedance is always written as 1/SC and resistance will remain as R. Okay, so how do you get the output voltage? You have to use the voltage division principle. Voltage division principle. So I'm sure you will be learning this in electrical networks. What does voltage division principle state? It states that V0 of S, I'm directly writing in Laplace domain, okay? So V0 of S is equal to input into the output impedance, 1/SC divided by total impedance. Okay? So if I bring this thing here, you get V0 of S divided by V of S. That is nothing but the transfer function G of S is, if you try to simplify this thing, 1/SC by R plus 1/SC, you will get 1/1+RCS. Yes, 1/1+RCS. Okay, and if you compare it with this transfer function, you will notice that T is equal to RC. Okay, what is this T called in first order systems? This T is nothing but the time constant of this. Why is it called time constant? We will soon learn. So G1 of S is equal to 1/1+ts, where T is the time constant of the system. Okay. Now, so what is the pole of the system? To find out the pole of the system, you just do 1/1+st, or rather the denominator 1+st equal to 0. So S is equal to -1/T. Okay, so you can have wherever is the pole position, that is your -1/T. Okay, so this particular system, this is example one and this is example two. In example one, the pole is very the pole is very near the J omega axis, and in example two, the pole is quite far away from the J omega axis. Okay, so in which case will the value of capital T be high? Is it in this case or is it in this case? In which case will the value of capital T be very high?
First case.
In the first case, T will be high. Why? Because in the first case, 1/T is very small, because it is quite near the J omega axis, which means T is high. Okay, which means this has a high time constant. Okay, so here basically T is high, and in this example T is low. So as you move the first order pole away and away from the J omega axis, what you are doing is you are basically decreasing the time constant of the system. And as you push the pole towards the J omega axis, what you are doing is you are increasing the time constant of the system. Okay. So now we have been talking about the time constant for a very long time. Let us see what actually it means. For that, you will have to learn what is the step response of a first order system. OK, Okay, so we have already seen that g1 of s is 1 by 1 plus ts. For a step response, we have r of s, which is the input, is equal to 1 by s. Given r of s and g1 of s, the question is, how do you find out c of s? Since we know g of s is nothing but output by input Laplace transform, rearranging, you get c of s is equal to g1 of s multiplied by r of s. Now, what is g1 of s? 1 by 1 plus ts. What is r of s? 1 by s. Okay, so this is nothing but 1 by s into 1 plus ts. That is c of s. Okay, now in the Laplace domain, c of s is equal to 1 by s into 1 plus ts doesn't give us much useful information. What we need to find out is, we need to find out the time domain response, c of t. So how do you get c of t? C of t you get from the Laplace inverse of c of s. That is nothing but Laplace inverse of 1 by s into 1 plus ts. Okay, so there are many methods to actually find out Laplace inverse. For first order systems, there is a pretty easy method. So L inverse of 1 by s into 1 plus ts. What you do is, so I wouldn't write L inverse right now, just 1 by s into 1 plus ts. We want to break this into partial fraction. Okay, so what you do is, you just write out the two terms 1 by s and 1 by 1 plus ts. Okay, now you put a minus sign. Why do you need to put a minus sign is that? Because this 1 plus ts, if you cross multiply, if you take the LCM and try to simplify, 1 plus ts will go to the numerator here and s will go to the numerator here. And if you have a minus sign, it is only then that the s term will get cancelled off. Because in the numerator, we don't want any s term. Okay? However, for the s term to get cancelled off, remember there is a t here. So 1 plus ts will come over on the numerator on this side. If you want the ts to be cancelled on the right hand side, what you need to do is, you simply add a t here. Okay, let us check if this is equal to this. If you take the LCM, s into 1 plus ts, so you get 1 plus ts minus ts. Right, that is equal to 1 by s into 1 plus ts. Okay, so this is a pretty quick method to find out the partial fraction for first order systems. So what you do now, L inverse of this is nothing but L inverse of this. Okay, now what is L inverse of 1 by s? L inverse of 1 by s is nothing but the unit step input, right? And L inverse of t by 1 plus ts, that is equal to L inverse of t, you can take outside, 1 by 1 plus ts, right? That is equal to t times, or rather, don't take t outside. There is another method to do this. This is nothing but L inverse of 1 by, you divide by t on both the numerator and denominator, s plus 1 by t. Okay, so if you would have remembered your Laplace transform classes in signals or systems or control systems, you would recognize that L inverse of 1 by, so this is 1 by s plus a form. So this is e power minus a t, right? So this becomes e power minus t by capital T into u of t, the step response. Okay, so if you combine this and this with the negative sign, what you are getting, the step response of a first order system, c of t is equal to 1 minus e power minus t by t into u of t. Okay, now if you try to plot this, response, let us first draw the step input. Okay, so this is R of T. And now if you try to draw C of T, this is basically a rising exponential. Okay, how did I suddenly get that this is a rising exponential? Was it magic or something? No. You just need to plot C of T for various values of T. So T and C of T. At T is equal to 0, okay, C of T has to be 0 because this e power minus T by T is 1. Okay.
Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed watching this video, then don't forget to like, comment and share the video. Subscribe to Gate School and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Don't forget to register for our free live classes. Find the link in the description box. This is your chance to prepare yourself with personal trainers.